Let's see. Zipper up? Nope.
Anything hanging out?
Nope. Hey, boys! Hey, girl! How y'all doing today? We're gonna make some cabbage rolls. And these are gonna be smoky flavored cabbage rolls. Actually, with a smoked bacon tomato sauce. Okay. The recipe called for bratwurst stuffed cabbage rolls. But the bratwurst we have down here sucks. Got that mass produced stuff that tastes kind of like cardboard. It ain't no good. Our sausages just blow that away. The first thing that came to my mind was, why don't I go and get some smoked andouille and make cabbage rolls with that? But you folks wouldn't be able to reproduce it. Plus, I would hate, that would be like sacrilege to put smoked andouille in cabbage rolls. It's best just eaten straight. So I got some Aberdeen Farms hardwood smoked bacon, and I'm gonna cook. I'm gonna do half of this recipe, and it called for three slices of bacon in the whole recipe, but I'm gonna use three slices in the half version of the recipe, and I'll put a link to this recipe in the description box for you folks. So I got a pan lined with foil. I'm going to put three strips of bacon on there and cook them in the oven. Okay. I'm also going to tighten it up to something that's not in the recipe. Well, they've got paprika in the recipe, but it's just plain paprika. I got some smoked paprika here that I buy in bulk. I say in bulk. I go to Whole Foods and get how much I need. This is how much I got right now. So that's going to add another layer of smoke flavor to this. Yum. I just noticed I had a hole in my shirt. So I put this little boy in there. See that? Good boy. That's my pet Boudreaux. Just got the bacon out the oven. And let's pour that bacon grease in this pan. One of my Revere Ware pans. He gets to make a guest appearance in this video. Got a lot of them. I bought like two sets and then a couple of add-on pieces of Revere Ware way back, like 30 years ago. And they've been good to me. They last. So, turn the fire on. And let's get some onion. This is a kind of small onion, small, medium, small, and some red bell pepper. And put in that. I'm trying not to eat that damn bacon. You know that's going to be tough. So let's sweat this down. I'm going to go ahead and put a little bit of pepper on that. Salt, if I can find what I've done with it. Come here, salt. Yeah, how you go? Let's worry that around in there with some kind of apparatus. Not your hand, it's too hot. Now after them done cooked down for about 4 minutes, let's go ahead and add some garlic. Cut the fire down on medium low. I've been worrying it about. Now the original recipe called for beer, when that's for bratwurst. But I'm using beef. And beef works better with wine. So a half a cup of wine. A can of mash up Maters. Oh, look, they're Italian style too. Good. That means they got extra seasonings and flavors in it. And that was a dry Cabernet Sauvignon. A white, red wine. Now we need some caraway seeds. It's about two pinches. One more pinch. If you got this ground, use that. I don't feel like grinding this. 2 pinches of that. Let's see. A couple pinches of smoked paprika. Heaping. Now, stir that around and bust the bacon up and put it in there too. We're gonna let this sit here and reduce. Busting the bacon up and putting it in there. Okay. Eating the piece. Yum. Stir that around. Let me go rinse my hands off. You stir it, gammer. So this has got to reduce. See the liquid in here? This whole thing can burn very easily. So you got to be real careful with it. You could actually put this in the fridge and do it later if you wanted to. If you're not ready to eat, or you can actually make the cabbage rolls and put them in the fridge and then finish them off in the oven later. But I'm not finished. I'm not finished drinking pops yet. So what I'm gonna do with it to let it reduce without me having to worry about it burning is put my oven down on a low temperature, like about 180. Look over there, boy, 180. And you put this pan in that oven and let it simmer in there. And it's gonna hold that temperature. The fire doesn't know what temperature it's at. The fire doesn't know what temperature it's at. It just knows it's a fire. So as the volume reduces, the temperature in the pan starts coming up on a burner, any kind of burner. So your stuff can stick and burn. You put it in an oven, and as the volume reduces, the oven thermometer is going to maintain the temperature. The controls on your cooktop are stupid. All they know is medium, low, medium, high, or in between, somewhere there in between. They won't hold a temperature setting. The oven will. I've never shared that with y'all, have I? Now you know. I'm gonna go play with my crawfish. Come on, boy. Let's go swimming and drink pops with foam on top. And then we'll complete this dish. Actually, I'm gonna go watch another episode of the Bible, the Epic Mini Series. Good stuff. So I measured out a half a cup of rice. This is extra long grain rice. And I need to put 1 cup of water in this pot. Use diet water. One cup, and we're gonna need a scant amount of salt. I'd like that. It's probably a quarter of a teaspoon of just plain diet salt, yeah. Let's go bring this to the boil. Let's add our rice to the boiling water. Let the water return to a boil. Which it should do very quickly. Once it returns to a boil, give it another stir. Okay. Reduce the heat to low. Simmer, cover the pot, 20 minutes. Do not open the pot. Do not be set a timer. Our sauce has been reducing in the oven. As you can see, the liquid's mostly cooked out of it. I think the recipe called for a puree. It's all right. This will be just fine. I need this pan, so I'm going to transfer this to a holding container. So let's go ahead and put it in here, getting all of it out, drinking more pops as needed. I need to brown some grind meat in here. Now, if you was going to be using bratwurst, you would cook that in here after you peeled it out of the casing. All right, I just put some grind meat in the pan with a little bit of Earl, and I took the outer leaves off of a head of cabbage, rinsed them, and put them in a pot of boiling water, and shut the fire off. You do have to season your grind meat too, by the way. Put whatever kind of seasoning on there you would like, salt and pepper, it don't matter. Unless you're using bratwurst, then don't season it. Stupid camera. I drained some of the grease out of the grind meat into this thing here. And we're gonna go ahead and drain the rest of it into there, into a colander. And we threw it this plate for now. Let that drain. So I got my cabbage leaves in here, and they've been cooled off. I put some ice in the water to stop the cooking process. Can you see over there? We got a timer. That means our rice is ready. So let's go ahead and put our meat mixture back in the pan. Has been drained. Put our rice in there. See right there? Shut up, timer. Rice. Get him out. Pour him in there. The rice is seasoned and the grind meat is seasoned. So let's mix this all about. And I may have let it cook a little bit too long. That's okay. Don't worry about that. It's going to be just fine. We do want to check this for seasoning now. Normally when Miss JB makes this, she under seasons this part of the meal, of the dish. And you don't want to do that. Want to make sure this is plenty flavorful. Mm-hmm. Close, but it needs some more. I'm glad I checked. So I'm going to add some Cajun seasoning and stir that in. So the reason I saved some of this grease, because they said to spray this pan down with a non-stick spray. But we already got this grind meat grease right there. Worry that around in there. And it's free. You ain't gotta go buy nothing now. See? Now, non-stick. Okay. And it'll enhance a flavor. The flavor. Imagine that. Oh, don't you go nowhere, boy. Cut your ass. Like a bad habit. So now, let's go on and get us some stuffing and put it in a cabbage roll, in a cabbage head, leaf, wrap it up and put it over there. See, over, that's over there, right there. Repeat. Let me do it. Now, I didn't have enough cabbage rolls to fill the whole pan. So I put a couple pieces of sacrifice cabbage in this end. And now we're going to go ahead and dump our gravy on it. And we ain't worried about that end. I'm sure you barely eat that too. You can also, at this point, go ahead and wrap this in foil and keep it in the fridge. Okay? And cook it tomorrow. Yum, yum, yum. Smoky yumness on my fingers. Cover it in foil, 350, about 40 minutes. Did you know, while we're messing with cabbage, you can actually take and cut the stem off the end, remove the outer leaves, rinse it off, and then quarter it and grill it. Put some oil on it and some salt and pepper and grill it. And it takes on a nutty, rich, kind of like mushrooms do when they're cooked. Cabbage does the same thing. You can also take it, here's what's left of what I got. You can also take it and dig a well inside of it, removing the stem and core, the whole head now, not piece of head like this one, and put a stick of butter, salt and pepper, a lot of salt and pepper, as a matter of fact, inside the head after it's been cored out, so you got a well up inside of there, and smoke it. Oh yeah, baby. You take it, and what you want to do with it is wrap about halfway up on the outside. So like, if this was a whole cabbage head, you'd wrap it up to about here with foil, and there'd be a hole in here with a stick of butter and a good tablespoon of salt, pepper, garlic powder, whatever you want to put in there, and go smoke it. Done that a long time ago. I don't think I ever did it on video. I know I got a picture of it sitting on there, and yum. Oh man, that thing sucks up smoke like a sponge. Oh yeah, baby. We have cabbage rolls tonight. Yeah, Miss JB's better at rolling them cabbages up than I am. A couple of them was kind of not rolled very well, and I'm sure they're not going to come out the pan very well, but they eat just damn fine. And I'm sure I'll eat that whole pan too, just like I did that whole rack of ribs just yesterday. Yesterday, yeah. That's what I said. I hope I don't get them out of order. Not the titties, the days. Being retired, we don't care no more. Just the hell you want. eat, drink beer till it's time to eat again and go to bed. Ha! So get your leftover cornbread and cut it in half. And get you some butter. Go put it in a cast iron skillet. And we're going to fry this again to warm it up. Because this has been in the refrigerator. And it's just dying for some butter. Yep, me too. Let's go on and put us some butter in a skillet. And get it melted down. Good and proper. I got about a half a stick of butter in here. And here's that cornbread that I made. And we're going to put it in that butter and let it fry down again after it's been cut in half. Oh, yeah. There's a little lanyard piece right there. Yum, let it suck up some of that butter and fry a little bit. Yum. Fresh out the damn oven. Fresh on my plate with some twice fried cornbread. Let's get some stills.